baatuwerezanga wano bujips bulike mmundu ne buyita mukaba kanjagala ne budde eri.
Jehoash Mayanja Nkangi's political activism was clearly seen in 1953 when the British exiled the Kabaka of Buganda, Sekabaka Edward Mutesa II. As a young man deeply loyal to Buganda Kingdom, the British had made a move that would change the young Nkangi's future. By then, he was at Oxford University in England pursuing a master's degree in philosophy, politics and economics. He was among the first Ugandans to get a government scholarship to study in Oxford. When he graduated and returned in 1959, the following year he was elected to lead the United Party, which later merged with the Uganda National Congress. Much later, he founded another party, the Uganda National Party. The agitation for Uganda's independence was high on the agenda of every local political grouping. So Nkangi decided to join a more formidable party, the Kabaka Yeka, or KY. He formed a youth wing for the party and went on to represent Masaka in the post-independence National Assembly on the KY ticket in May 1962. In 1964, at the age of 33, Kabaka Mutesa elected him Katikkiro of Buganda, following Michael Chintu's dismissal over the controversial Lost Counties issue.
Who do you give me as Katikkiro? Understand that Katikkiro said that the one I would give you would not accept him. Said, why? Because he's not married. And also, he's young. So I understand, I wasn't there. I understand the Kabaka asked, who is he? Mayanja Nkangi said, oh, was I married when I became Kabaka?
Until 1966, when Milton Obote's government abolished kingdoms and forced Mutesa into exile, Nkangi was Katikkiro, and he too fled into exile in Kenya and later England, only to return when Idi Amin overthrew Obote. Nkangi kept the instruments of power of the Katikkiro's office, which comprised of the ceremonial Damula stick, until in 1993 when Buganda Kingdom and others were restored. He later handed over office to Joseph Mulwanyah Mulisa Mwogerere. Nkangi served under President Obote's first regime as Parliament Secretary to the Minister of Economic Affairs in the early 60s. He was later appointed the Minister of Commerce and Industry. He resigned when the Kabaka Yeka and UPC broke their alliance in 1966. In 1980, he formed the Conservative Party, CP. He claimed he was still the CP leader when serving in President Yoweri Museveni's government, where he was from 1986 for about 15 years. He served in different portfolios, in education, Attorney General, Justice and Constitutional Affairs, and Finance until in 2001 when he retired. In 2010, he was appointed Chairman of the Uganda Land Commission, a position he held until 2013.
Incidentally, some people say the Baganda were the villains of the peace. That's why their kingdom was removed. I asked the question, what did the Banyoro do? But Obote removed the Obukama. What did the Batoro do? He removed the Obukama.
Born on 22nd August 1931, Nkangi went to Kabungo Masaka for primary school, King's College Budo, and Makerere College, present day Makerere University, where he attained a degree in economics in 1953 and later Oxford University for his master's. He witnessed much of the pre-independence Uganda politics and the events leading to the attack on the palace of the Kabaka in Mengo in 1966. Nkangi was penning his autobiography story in a book with the working title, Out of Empire into Servitude. He is survived by a widow and six children.